blacker than the deepest night, more bitter than the fires of hell itself. That is coffee.
Good morning. Let me actually go over to this one. Good morning from Australia. My name is Matt Nahat. Hey, Dragon. Good to see you. Look at that nice hat. Yes, it's lovely. Oh, lovely. All right. Welcome, welcome. Today we are going to be playing the last session of the Beginner Box for Pathfinder 2nd Edition with our lovely players here. It's been a real fun time. I think we've really enjoyed playing with each other. And we're looking and discussing what might be next for us in the land of role-playing games. But for tonight, we are going to continue with our current characters that are pre-generated with Ezrin, Kyra, Valeros, and Mariziel. And we're going to be getting into the last section of this game. So it'll be very exciting. It's good to have everyone here. Because I'm mostly here for my players, you know, we're publishing this on Twitch, but I'm mostly here for my players, so I'm not going to be honoring any redeems while we are in game. If you do a sing mode, I will do it at the end of the stream once we're finished with the game, but I'm not going to be doing it during because I'm here for the players primarily. Okay, so if you want to do that, that's fine, but it'll happen after the stream. Well, at the end of the stream. All right, with that out of the way, let's introduce our cast and see what everybody's been up to and where we can find them. So, over to you, DM Nyx. Let us know who you are, where we can find you, what you're playing, and what you've been up to. Yes.
But yeah, I just finished up my Hasbro Chronicles.
Yeah.
I'm disappointed it's over, but it was awesome. It was a good game. It was a fun ride. If you guys haven't done that, check it out. I'll probably be on tomorrow decided to bite the bullet and spend some money to try to speed up production of Chapter 2 for Cyberpunk.
Okay. Hey, Axe, good to see you. Oh, good to see you, Axe. Ooh, I got some. Why are we doing echoes? Let me fix echoes. Okay, good. Echoes are fixed. All right, we'll go over to Lady Vengeance.
Monday, my Tuesday. Hi, Lady Vengeance in the house. I split my time between Twitch and Kick, same name on both, so I'm nice and easy to find. At the moment, I had a look last night. I have a lot of Warhammer 40k content going on at the moment. Painting miniatures at the moment, they're orcs on Mondays and Wednesdays. Dark Tide on a Tuesday. I started doing Black Tail on a Thursday night this week, which was rather exciting. So that's an interesting game about a young version of Baba Yaga, which is an interesting folk tale. Scary story for the kids. And last night, Matt and I, we started Inquisitor Martyr and got to the beginning of Chapter 3. So, yeah, it's fun game. So we're up to a point where I haven't actually progressed past, but in saying that, although I did that on Twitch last night, next week I will be taking it over to Kick because I am having some Friday night technical issues with Twitch. So, yeah, next week that will be on Kick as long as we go ahead with it. Aside from that, I am looking to do a few other different little bits and pieces, but as yet undecided on how I'm going to implement them into my schedule.
Still need to figure out again who our third is.
Raven Rolls, thank you for subscribing. Why is that so loud? Let me turn that down. Hopefully that has played. Let me know if that played, please.
I have you down low. I saw the video, but I don't know if the audio played because I have you down, so I don't hear you twice. No offense.
No.
I don't really like listening to myself that much.
All right, well, while we're looking at that, we'll go over to Table Knights.
Hi. That's me.
Tell us about yourself. Perfect.
The drowner of rats and the slayer of slimy salamanders. I have been doing Origins. Gen Con is the next one that will be happening. I was at Origins the past weekend, and I actually met the studio that is in charge of Vampire the Masquerade,
ooh,
aka By Night Studios, and I got to have dinner with the CEO, and I talked business with them. It was wild!
That's insane, man!
Yeah, no, I decided to bring business cards with me on this trip, because my therapist was like, you should start taking yourself more seriously. And I was like, okay, well, I guess. And so I did, and then that happened, and now I'm like, well, I should just have business cards with me all the time. And constantly be networking, et cetera, because at the end of the day, no matter what industry you're in, it doesn't matter what you're doing unless you know how to talk to people and... get them to trust you in some capacity. That's the Deep Table Knights lore here. Really, I'm just manipulating everything. I'm a great social engineer, a horrifying monster, deep inside.
Okay. Well, we're back to thank you for all of that. It's great to have you here. We're back to my sound alerts being dicks and not working. Even though I can actually see the volume in my OBS, like I can see it playing, but it is not playing. What? So I don't know. I don't know what's going on. So thank you for the gifted sub. Thank you for the Prime subscription, Raven Rolls. Man, that is ridiculous. Thank you so much. Man, I'm feeling real humbled this week. We are going to get into the game here. So, here we are. I need to jump over to this screen real quick and copy these tokens. And then we're going to go to floor 2. And I need to activate that when we're ready. Activate, unpause. And we're going to be over here. And we should have some new. So we've got a riding dog, a houndmaster. Where is the other riding dog? What have you done? We just, yeah, it's underneath. Okay, cool. So we have Houndmaster Loxy with us. Release the hounds! Yeah.
Smart dog. Very good.
Refresh. I'm just going to try and refresh all of these sound alerts and things and see if that fixes it real quick. Because I don't like it that I've set all this up and checked everything. And it's still not working. I don't like it. Nope. Refresh. Okay. So, yes, we have a Houndmaster with us who is going to be assisting us in battle. And his two riding dogs. Now, he is not as good as a normal Houndmaster, because in the system or in the adventure we don't get help, but I, in my wisdom as a DM and in trying to help my players to achieve what they want to achieve, have been gracious enough to honor their roles and allow them to gain the assistance of this Houndmaster. So here you are, in the dungeons, well, dungeons, underneath the fishery. Back at the mermaid well, and ready to finish off the adventure by travelling north.
There, interrogate him quietly.
That would be a good hope, Val. Well done using your brain the right way and not as a battering ram.
I slap him. I know strategy. Fighting, I'm smart at.
Mm-hmm.
Words, not so much.
All right. So yeah, you have your setup there. You can advance your characters to where you want to be.
I kept hitting the wall, sorry.
No, you're okay.
What a Val thing to do.
So now that she's in here, so my dear wife here decided that she likes this game enough that she's willing to allow it to be our date night.
Ooh! That is...
The holy lady. Praise be.
You should feel very special that I'm letting you be part of our date night. We're like, on a double date-ish. Not really.
They're not dating, so that's kind of awkward.
It's not a double date. It's a friend date.
But it's more that you like it enough that it's at least acceptable that it says something.
That is...
Everyone here is attractive and interesting. I'd date anyone here.
We're adventuring.
All right.
So to the north of us, up this area, you know that there is a group of kobolds led by Zolgran, who you've spoken to, who told you, in no uncertain terms, go away. And you said, okay, we will go away. And then we will come back, right? So...
to the beast.
Hey, that's fucked up. They're people. People we're gonna kill.
No, they are not human. They are.
I didn't say human.
They are.
They're people.
No, they are beasts. They are choosing to be beasts.
Listen, we just don't understand. Honestly, it's like, you know, 1329, as I think you need to look at yourself and kind of question that kind of thought process. I mean, maybe that's why they're acting like this, because they expect people to just think that of themselves. All right, now is everybody ready to just go stab them to death?
Yep. Let's go.
Val just looks at Ez, disappointed in you.
Well, you know, a beast is someone who chooses to act like that.
There we go. Finally figured out that audio setting. Okay.
So
we're getting there.
Question, DM.
Yes.
Am I supposed to know that there's traps here?
What traps? Come on.
The traps that I didn't see that aren't there.
No, they're clearly not there. They're clearly... There's nothing there. What are you talking about?
Wink wonk. All right,
you can't see anything. You can make a seek check if you like.
No, I'm role playing Val as Val, who is stupid and brave and ready to die. Yep, there we go. Go ahead. I accept this.
All right. So yes, let me pull this out. I need.
Better be a cool trap.
Oh, it's just the same as we've had before. So, a reflex save there for you, Val. And you succeed, which means that you take half this damage, which will be 6.
Ow!
Oh!
It just stabs right through my foot. I look down. I look at Ez. This is your fault. Ow!
It's really not.
He distracted me.
Alright.
Alright.
I distracted you, Val. You need to focus.
Mr. Lizard Dickhead. You there?
It was actually a Ms. Lizard Dickhead.
Oh, I don't wanna misgender the lizard. Miss Lizard Cloaca Head. There we go. That's more appropriate.
Before we keep going, Mariziel, I need you
Damn
please
it, Miri.
To make You're me a reflex like save. As you set off yet another trap. Alright, you're going to take full damage. Because even while you have gone to prepare, so have the kobolds.
What did I say last night?
Ow!
I can't promise that I'm not going to get myself killed today.
And as you get to there, you will see that there are several kobolds waiting for you.
I'm confused. We didn't see him past the gorge?
I don't think that's a gorge. I think that's... I assumed that was just a wall. So, can you...
It looks like a hole to me.
Okay, it might be a hole.
My bad.
I'm saying it's a wall, so it's a wall. All right.
That
so,
bus.
And this is there, and that is there.
Oh, poor Miri. Oh no.
I'm dead.
Why didn't you stay behind the tank?
Just fucking kill me already.
Yeah.
Do it, pussy.
All right. So let's end this one. All right. So, you guys knew that there was several kobolds down here, and you just came walking on in, no stealth checks, nothing, just walk on in, nothing could possibly go wrong, so here is where we kill you. Okay, let's go. So, create encounter, roll initiative, please.
Listen, I just want it noted, I was trying to be a distraction.
Mm-hmm. You did that very well.
Yes, you distracted Mary from using her mind. Well done. Excellent.
I can't hear you as over the sound of Mary's death rattle.
Oh, that is harsh.
Initiative. Let's go. 24!
Apparently I'm still on my toes somehow.
And I might have to turn down the volume of the playlists because these kobolds are very loud! In fact, I might even turn that off yet. Because that is very annoying. Let's do ambient noises down. Maybe that will help. All right. Okay. Does this have a track? That's much better. Audio cue. Sure, let's do that. Oh, that's a little bit later. Okay. So I think I've rolled for everything. So what is happening at the moment? Zolgran is up here. You can see her. But at the moment, she is rolling initiative. However, she is going to stay out of it. And she's just going to be like, you can deal with these interlopers. And she is going to wait and watch with gleeful eyes. And say, once we have dealt with these surface dwellers, we will invade their pitiful town. Yes.
With what army? We've killed like half your people.
Alright, so, with that, Kobold Scout this one right next to Mary will fire a crossbow at her. Strike.
Quick question. I put another one on for Kyra's spells.
Yeah.
Since there's a slot there for it, but it didn't put it in.
Okay, one second.
Did I miss something?
Maybe. We will find out here.
So if I click spell preparation, it shows it, but then it doesn't show it on the list.
Okay. I'll drag something to the list. Which spell did we drag?
I was just going to give her another Burning Hands for now.
Sure.
Probably not the best, but it's, you know, keeps us rolling without any interruption.
Yep. No, that's right. I will grab that and put that in there. Might have just been for spell preparation, so we can just drag it down. There we go.
Okay. That worked. Thank you.
Not a problem. So it misses with its crossbow. It will then drop its crossbow. It will leap down to your level. And it will pull out its short sword. And that's all of its turn. So it is now wielding a short sword. And it's right next to you there. We have to begin this. Okay, Velaros. There is a scout right there. Has a short sword equipped.
All right. Do we still have elemental aid, or did that go away?
We still have everything that... Yeah, we still have the elemental aid. Spend an action, can fly, or spend an action to make your strikes deal 2 extra damage.
Cool. I'm gonna fly.
Mm-hmm.
To... her.
Moving up to up to 40 feet. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, you can get to there.
Dope. You. Oh, hold on. It's not.
Yeah, see, they're not expecting you to fly.
Yeah. I was just like, peace out, bitches.
Does this one... I just need to check that they don't have an attack of opportunity or anything. They don't. Okay, so yeah. You just take off, and they're like, wow!
And then I'm gonna use the strong thing that makes me do harder attack. You know.
So we've used that one, and... Okay, so if you... Okay, yep, sure.
Shit.
That's okay.
Didn't mean to right-click it.
Well, you're using it, so...
damage with it?
Yes. We can just calculate that manually.
Okay, so I select target, select her, roll the hit. Are you... Did it not?
Oh my! He's on fire!
Okay...
Okay, that's weird. It didn't, record it before. I was going to use a hero point if that missed.
It,
the 15.
It hits. The 15? No, because you rolled damage rather than attack. 1d20? Oh, no, you didn't. So that 15 will not hit.
Okay, so then I used my hero point, and that's...
And then you got the hit. Okay, gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sorry, I was trying to figure out why it didn't tell me whether or not it hit, because normally it did. Damage, 9 plus 2 is 11.
Okay, 11 points. Alright, I will apply that.
I also now have Intimidating Strike. Your blow not only wounds creatures, but also shatters their confidence. Make a melee strike. If you hit and deal damage, the target is frightened 1 or frightened 2 on a critical hit.
Okay, so with Intimidating Strike, you have to declare that you're doing that, and it's an extra action to do that.
Okay, so this would be two actions. Okay, so never mind then. I won't do that.
Yep, so Intimidating Strike is two actions. You say, I'm going to Intimidating Strike. And then if you hit on that one, then the effects happen. It's not just on any attack. But thank
Got
you.
It.
But, yep, taking the damage. You've gotten there. You've done extra damage. You've attacked. And that is your turn.
I moved. I attacked. Don't I have one more action?
Well, you used your buffs.
Slide to connection.
Yeah, that's my move, isn't it?
You what used move? your earth buff as well.
Using those as an action?
That's what I said.
It's an action to use.
Got it. Okay.
All right, Mary.
Well, there's really only one thing I can do, isn't there?
Fly, bitch.
No.
I mean, it was very effective. Yeah. Zogran is actually hurt.
Yeah, but there's no guarantee that if I go to her, these guys aren't going to instantly ping everyone else. Which definitely puts us at a disadvantage if we do need that lovely healing. Maybe. So I am going to go for the one that's right in front of me here.
Yep.
Ugh. God damn it.
You miss.
What's that? That's one. Well, I've got two more. So I'm going to...
Yep, so you...
So that one was with the short sword. So I'm then going to follow up with the dagger.
There's literally no reason to do that. Your short sword is better in every single way.
I know, except when I go to make a second strike with it and I have a minus against me.
Yeah, but it evens out because it's a plus one short sword.
Oh, okay. All right. I don't like numbers.
So yeah, numbers using your short sword for everything at this point is fine.
It's still... I fall on my short sword. Sorry. I mean, they did say everything. All right, so try the second roll on the short sword.
Yep.
I'm just like, no this is not working.
Okay, do you want to make move away at this point, or...?
Yeah, no, that's my attempt to move. How far can I move?
Up to 25, I think, actually, you're an elf, right? So I think you should have 30 feet.
30?
Yeah, I think so.
Alright, so
yeah, 30 feet.
I only need to go 15 to get out of the way anyway. So
okay.
I'm going to come all the way back here.
Ooh, nice. All right. And with that, Zogran, as you have flown unexpectedly up to her, she will target you, Valoros. And she'll be like, I did not expect that.
Yeah, that's why I did it.
Toss a coin to your witcher, O Valley of Plenty, O Valley of Plenty.
Okay.
Oh.
Thank you for the 20 bits, Dragon Playing Worm. Appreciate you. And you got an actual sound alert. Congratulations. We actually fixed it again. All right. Going to cast Magic Missile. And you take all of that.
Okay.
The hell?
As
wild man.
So how this looks, you will see spittule coming out of her mouth, and you will see that sort of coalescing into like icy balls, and then those will like catapult towards you, Val, and no matter what you do to raise your shield or anything, they fly just straight at you. You've seen Ezran do something like this with his magic missiles, and they just hit every time, no matter what. They slam into you, and they just feel like someone's, you know, punched you really hard when you've not got armor on, or hit you with a maul in battle, and it quite severely hurts. And she'll crack a smile and she'll go, "I bet you weren't expecting that either."
Actually, I was. I've seen it a bunch of times. Yeah, how does it feel? You feel stupid now?
And because she has cast a spell, you have an attack of opportunity that you can employ.
Do it.
All right. So, what do I roll for that? Just like my normal attack?
Yeah. So you'll target her and you just roll a normal strike without any penalties. You miss as she sort of, manages to fall back a little bit. And
can I use my last hero point on that?
Do you have another one?
I just have the one more. That's it.
Sure. No.
I'll use the other one, thank you.
With this, we're going to have a little bit of fun, Val. Val, as you go for this strike, she dodges back at the last minute, and your sword comes clanging down on her throne and jars your hand, and you drop your sword.
Val's like, fuck it, I didn't need it anyway.
So your sword, if you could please press the drop button on your sword, it is now on the ground. You'll have to spend an action to get it again.
I'm just going to beat the piss out of her with my fist.
Ezran.
Well, Val, I wish you'd waited a moment to make a statement. But, you know, duck.
Quack?
Okay. And these...
You get to experience more shards come flying over his head.
At Xolgren?
Yes.
All right. Damage. And damage. And damage. Alright, she is looking very wounded at this point.
Val! I got you!
Thanks!
Ah, these adventurers are more powerful than I thought. Kill them! Now!
As opposed to later?
Kobold
Scout.
I want
to do both, right? Because then you could have your now and later.
He's going to drop sword, quip, crossbow, and shoot at Ezran. Because you've got magic missile, and that's bad.
Do I get cover from being behind someone?
Yes. Misses, reloads, so that's everything from the scout. Warriors are going to... Ooh, this one is going to come to here and attack you, Ezran, with a spear strike. Miss hits with 6 points of damage. Moved once, attacked once, and attack second time. Misses, and As it, as you sort of like step back against this one, it overreaches and you hear sort of a click of its elbow, and it drops the spear in its spot. Right. Next kobold warrior is going to climb the stairs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, I also have that one. I'll get to that. Let me see that one. That'll be, yeah, later. Cool. It'll move to there. It'll target you, Val. Oops. Okay. And it will be a strike. Misses. And second attack. Misses. All right. So, yeah, you block that one, but looks like you're starting to get some around you. Kyra?
Yes. So you have one right next to you with a spear that just stabbed me.
That's not good.
Yeah.
I have my crossbow, right?
Yeah, you said you wanted your crossbow out, so that's out right now. So
yeah.
Not the best thing in melee, so you might need to drop it and stab with your scimitar instead.
Mm-hmm. And also, we haven't, because we came charging in willy-nilly without preparation, you haven't yet cast Magic Weapon, and it would be helpful to Mary to do that at some point.
That's two actions.
Mm-hmm. So it is up to you. Yeah, I'm just giving you options, letting you know that there's multiple things you can do.
So what does Magic Weapon do?
Okay, so it will cast onto Mary's weapon, and Mary's weapon will do an extra die of damage when she hits with it. And that will last for an entire minute. Every time that she hits with it, it will do more damage.
And that's on top of her already plus one weapon? Because plus one isn't an extra dice, right?
It's correct, just... yeah.
Okay. That's me wanting to make sure I understand it. Thank you.
Okay, so I can either drop my crossbow and get my scimitar, or I can do magic weapon.
Well, you can do both of those things, all of those things. You just can't hit with your scimitar this turn if you do the magic weapon. But you can equip it.
Okay. Is Mary about to have her turn, or she'd already have it?
She will be having it soon.
Fairly soon, yeah.
Oh, okay.
So you're here. Then it's gonna be this kobold scout, and then Mary's gonna go.
Mm-hmm.
Well, then Val, then Mary. It wouldn't hurt. How close to bleeding or? Oh, you're also hurt pretty bad. Ah! Why do you do this to us, Mary?
Fun.
Yeah, you could also heal Mary. You do have battle medicine now.
It's worth doing treat wounds and then do magic weapon.
Yeah.
Not ideal, but it would be worth doing.
Okay.
Do you want to do that?
Yeah.
All right, so battle medicine. First time it's being used because you only just got it at this level because you're level 2 now. So, yeah, you can roll a medicine check. Oh, you could use your hero point if you want. At the moment, that is not succeeding.
You're off by 1 point. Do you want to use your hero point or not?
All right, so you will spend that hero point, and then you will re-roll it again. And hopefully do better. By one or more, even more. You do succeed. And Mary, you get that 12 hit points. You can heal that. There you go. As she does that. And then you're casting magic weapon. Excellent. And we will drag that spell effect over. And it's going to be on there. There you go. Done.
And then Mary needs to start stabby stabby.
Yes. Which she kind of has already started, but... All right.
Now she'll stabby stabby more.
Yes. And then... this one will come out of stealth and make his way to here and try and stabby stabby Val. Okay. Strike. Nope. And second strike. Slams the weapon into the big pillar. Yay. And drops it. Okay.
Yay!
Everyone's dropping their weapons.
I did Val, does everyone have the dropsies today? Did your calendar say it's dropsy day or something?
I'm gonna drop you, old man, off a cliff.
Be nice, Val.
Now! I'm murdering!
All right.
I'm helping you with that.
This
he's just grumpy because he didn't get to keep his kobold.
One is gonna try, yeah, and make an athletics check, which it doesn't have, so it's not gonna do that. It
you
is
know,
gonna.
Val, I think he forgot to tell the Houndmaster to come with us.
Yes.
We couldn't control
indeed.
Him.
I need to
yeah,
do
I
that.
I was literally about to yell, "Release the hounds!" And
indeed.
Then kobold. Bet you weren't expecting
that. I will now do that. So, Houndmaster Lucky is now going to roll initiative because out of sight, out of mind. He is going to go down there. But what I'm going to do, in lieu of him not going last turn, I'm going to just move him up as if he went last turn. He is going to be right here. And his hounds are going to be ready to attack. All right. That will be fine. So he will go when it's his turn. The scout is going to make its way all the way up here and just train a crossbow on the party, but at the moment cannot do that. Val, it is back to you.
All right. As I'm blocking all the little fellas with their pokey sticks with my shield, I'm just like, oh, God damn it. And I like scramble for my sword and I grab that.
So you spend an action picking that up.
There you go. And then double right click. Bam. Do the strikey do. Yeah. Suck it. Solgran, you bitch.
All right. She takes 9. And she is dead. Describe it.
Ha! So I pick up the sword and I, like, almost absentmindedly, Ez says, the thing he said last second, wow! And I'm like, what? And I turn around with the sword and I just lop her head off. Oh, shit. Oh, God. Okay. Well, that's effective. And then I'm going to turn to this one and I'm going to be like, all right, now I mean to kill you. And do one more attack.
Oh, Val, I think you may have removed the head. She wasn't a zombie, Val. She was just a lizard, but effective nonetheless.
Okay, you miss on that one. You swing too high.
You want to raise shield?
I can't. I picked up, I attacked twice.
Yep.
Oh, right.
Also, they haven't hit me one time.
True.
Mary, it is your turn.
Mary, stabby, 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 stab.
That is the idea. Well, since this one here is right in front of me, she's going to take her lovely short sword. Now, I'm just wondering, with the... Because I did have a quick look at the magic weapon.
The magic effect is on, so it auto-calculates for you.
Okay, so the bonus to attack roll and the extra damage all...
Yeah.
Account.
You can see next to your little, on your token, you see that little icon. When you select it, you'll see it listed. There's a little magic sword icon. Yeah.
Interesting. Alright, so short sword, striking that one.
Oh, you hit, alright.
Yeah, for the extra damage, I'm assuming it accounts for all of that too?
When you roll the damage, yeah.
Let's find out.
And if you watch, you click it, you can see it says 2d6.
And you rolled two ones. Oh, that's rough. All right, it takes the 6 points of damage and looks at you.
Let's try that again. At least I hit.
True.
You hit again. There you go. You finish it off.
That's better.
Alright, so that one's dead.
Now we're getting somewhere.
And I'll just move it out of the way for now, so that it's out of the way. There it goes.
So the next closest one...
It's one of... So probably this one, because this one's up. You would have to, like, scramble up the... So it moved all the way around to get up there.
Yeah. Well, I've only got one action left, so... I'm going to start moving across so that I can actually reach it next time.
Sure.
You should be able to move, I think, one more square towards it.
Yeah, if she wants to, she can, yeah. And Ezrin, it will be your turn.
My turn? Very well. I think I will contemplate which one we should kill.
All of them?
Maybe?
I mean, that is why we're here.
Would the one across from... Either the ones across from Val have cover from me?
I would think so. They're on an elevated platform, and I'm standing in front of them.
Yeah, those ones over there are. This one isn't in cover.
Then I will do that one.
Also, technically, you're standing behind a wall. You can't see them.
I can see them.
Well, not according to what...
It's all right. We'll suspend disbelief a little bit and say it is... We'll just say it's a pit, and we'll say that they were hiding, and I don't know, maybe they jumped out of the pit or something.
I thought it was a pit because it was letting me see across it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not trying to be a dick. I'm sorry if it's coming off.
No. It's all good. I misread the map.
The system automates a lot of it, so I kind of just assumed that it did it right.
Okay. So. Well, you're not getting that Ray of Frost off, unfortunately, unless you use a hero point. So it backfires in your hand, Ezrin, and you feel like cold numbing your fingertips, but you don't take any damage or anything.
Burr.
Just kind of stings. You got one action left. All right, damage that one.
Wow.
Kobold Scout, the one there, is going to pick up, drop the crossbow, pick up the... Oh no, because it wasn't... Well, did it shoot it? I can't remember. I think it did shoot. So drop the crossbow, equip the sword, target Lady Vengeance, and attack twice.
She dodges.
So strike the once. Nope. Strike the twice.
No!
Doing 4 points of damage to you.
That's okay.
Houndmaster commands his animals.
Hooray, doggies!
Doggies away!
Here's
25. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2.
All the kobolds are instantly distracted because all they want to do is hug and cuddle and pat the puppies.
1, 2, 3.
No? I wish.
4.
You have no idea how deeply I wish.
This one will get into flanking. Did I move the wrong one? Yes, I did. Let's swap that. And Houndmaster will come to here. Riding Dog will be there. And what has he got? He's got a whip, so he can actually reach that one up there.
Yeah. All right, quick question. Does this guy whip his dogs? Because after you kill these kobolds, I might need to free the dogs.
You
have not seen him whip the dogs.
You have not seen that, no.
Alright.
Ooh, boy!
Yeah.
God damn!
That's doubled, so 12 points. So, double. Oof, that's a real solid hit as it whips that, kobold scout.
I did 4 damage.
Or no, it was 2.
All right. Oof.
Are we sure he's not Indiana Jones in disguise?
Did you wait?
Did
you hit critical?
I doubled it. That's... Yeah. I just doubled it. Yeah.
Yeah, you can see it. 12. Yep.
Okay. This one is going to strike at Val. Boop. Misses. Second attack. Misses. Okay. They cannot hit you. Kyra, it is your turn. You are currently here.
No, that's the Houndmaster. He's friend.
Yeah, this guy's friend.
Yeah, the three figures are friendly. So you want to target kobold, kobold. Yeah, that's dead.
Can I reach?
You have your crossbow out because you didn't switch last time. So yes, you can.
But
yeah.
This is up. This is 10 foot up. You see the cliff right here?
Oh.
So no, you wouldn't hit him. So he's actually a good target, and that's okay. Pit we decided. So you could shoot over there too.
Yeah.
Okay, she's shooting for the one that the Houndmaster critted on.
I see it.
And
hopefully.
Strike.
Ooh.
Do you want to try again?
Yes.
Okay, reload. And shoot again. This will be at minus.
Hey!
Yeah, nice. You hit. Well, watch this. You ready? Boom! Got him!
Wow, holy shit.
So, how do you do that? Like, what does that look like? Where do you shoot him to kill him? Describe the kill.
Do it with precision?
Yes, I did it with precision. But I did miss the first time. I'm looking cocky like last.
Well,
game.
I mean, you fire once and you get where it's at, and you reload, fire a second time, and hit it in the forehead.
Yeah.
I saw our friend critted him, and he was almost down. So I said, "Hey, that's the guy!" And I pulled out my crossbow and bang.
Nice. Yeah. Catches it right in the chest, and as it sort of looks at you, the eyeballs roll into the back of its head, and it falls off the ledge and slams into the ground dead. All right, awesome, I love it. Kobold warrior is having to pick up the weapon and tries to hit Val feebly. Let's Let's see. Can these things hit you? Yes, they can. 7. And can he hit you again? No. And he slams the pillar again and drops the spear again.
Nerd.
Val, it is your turn. Slowly whittling away.
I'll go ahead and I'll hopefully not critically miss the one that's right in front of me.
You hit it.
I apologize, but yeah, that's definitely a hit. For 7 damage.
Alrighty. You can describe how you kill it.
So after I slice off the leader's head, he stabs me in like the shin, and I'm just like, "You mother!" And I kick him in the face, and he hits the wall. And I'm like, "You want some too?" And I look over to his buddy. I missed that one, but I'll raise my shield.
All right, raise your shield. Okay, Mary.
Did I do that right?
No.
There we go. Yeah.
Back to you, Mary.
Oh, it's good. I'm just taking on this very next one.
Right, and it is now flanked.
Yes.
Yay.
Because of dog.
Yay for dog.
Oh yeah, you hit
very well.
18, and you got 27. Let me just check something. You will actually critically hit because of the dog. It's not taking in that bonus because these are not marked as allies.
Too many things to try to take account of.
Yeah, it's all right. So it will take double the damage, and be far, far gone from this world.
26 damage. God damn.
Straight through the middle.
Mary, I think you found its heart.
Would you like it?
I don't tend to eat sentient beasts, so I'll pass for now. Thank you.
Could be a spell component.
Not when it's been eviscerated into oblivion.
I'll take it if you're offering. I waste not one, you know.
All right, you've got 2 more actions there.
I can't actually see anything else, but I'm assuming that there's one more up here somewhere.
Yes, there is.
Right there, indeed. Yeah.
Right there, indeed? Okay.
I can see just the edge of him from where I'm at.
Well, that's 30 feet.
Yeah, you can get there. Go for it.
Because you're lanky, elf. You get to move 30 feet.
Do the move. Now, that move, is that a 1 or a 2 action?
It's 1.
1.
Nice. Now... because it's a different target, I don't take a disadvantage to the strike, do I?
No, you do take a disadvantage to the strike.
Still a multi-attack penalty.
Still a multi-attack? Okay. Just clarifying.
Yeah, the penalty is because it's more than one attack on a turn, not just the same target.
Okay. That's okay. Honestly, though, like...
Unfortunately,
that
ducks.
That doesn't surprise me.
But now, what you did do is made it so Val can shift up 1, and he'll be flanking it with you.
Yeah. All right, so Ezrin, you see that most of the room is devoid of kobolds now.
I think he should chill out.
Oh, you hit. Ooh. Yeah, you describe it.
He just kind of like crystallizes with the cold and falls over and shatters into hundreds of pieces at Val's feet.
All right.
I think that was a smashing success.
I look over at the Houndmash and I'm like, all right, I'm going to be honest. I thought there was way more of these. They talked a huge fucking game.
Maybe they went deeper in. We should check if there's anything here and then move into...
Val,
verify. Like, I mean,
that's fair. But if there isn't, Houndmaster, could you just, like, say there was, like, 10 kobolds or something?
Val.
Listen, we've killed plenty of these guys.
Yeah, he says...
I found you something.
But, yeah, the guy says...
He says, if you do not touch Esmeralda again, yes, I might.
Who's Esmeralda?
The chick that you... It's his daughter, you remember? The from last time?
No, this is Val. Listen, I don't even know an Esmeralda. Is that one of the dogs?
No! You wooed his daughter and he challenged you about it. Anyway.
I don't remember this. Val, I don't remember. Listen.
It was last session, Val.
Val is brain dead.
That's fair enough.
Val, would you go ahead and reach in this chest, please?
Yeah, sure. I just stick my hand in it. Why am I doing this?
You're opening the inventory to the treasure.
That's okay, pretty. Cool.
I just have my hand in there, and then suddenly my hand catches on fire. Ow. and I'm like, I'm guessing it's the sword, right? That's what you're...
The sword and the potion. I thought it might be good to have on you. I guess the potion could go to Mary if you wish, if she takes more time.
Yeah, Mary is... How are you feeling, Mary?
A little sore. I do already have a healing potion if I do want to take one, so you can have that one.
Awesome. I take it.
So, treat wounds for Val. And Miri needs it. And I guess I could use it.
So, that 8 is for me?
Either one of you.
What are
you
doing? Do you
want to take that much time, or do we just want to patch up the two of you and let me hide behind you going forward?
I'll take the patch. And I'll be like, okay.
Well, then in that case, Miri doesn't get it.
That's fine. That seems to be the way of things with that check, honestly.
Right.
Second one doesn't. But I'm not hurting that much.
It makes me see the value, though, in assurance feat for that medicine check.
The dice are not to be trusted.
Exactly.
That is the only thing I'm getting out of this.
That's what the assurance feat does. It gives you a better, like, you can take a guaranteed 10 on the roll.
Yeah.
Which, when your skill is at +8, that means you make an 18 that passes the check.
So I'm looking over this sword. Is it just constantly sputtering smoke?
Let's see. Smoking sword. Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, it's got a fire magical smoke to it, yeah.
So Val's like, this is pretty neat.
I bet I can commit a lot of arson with this.
Val, no arson.
Who's gonna stop me? You and your little piddly cold stuff? I can melt it.
Go ahead.
What?
Go ahead.
And I look like Val's mother.
Val, behave yourself. You do not start any fires.
I hate my mother. She was mean to me. I'm just gonna commit more arson.
So the Hellmaster like looms like behind you as you sort of like turn and be like, "Who will stop me?" And he's crossing his arms. And he's looking at you and he's like, "You're unredeemable."
I'm of course joking, Luxie. I would never do that as a possible. All right, let's go.
He says, "Will this be all?"
Move in. We'll check further on. Make sure there's no more of the filth.
What is this dot that says the Lady Vengeance?
Lady Vengeance?
Oh, it's your cursor. Oh my god. I saw a dot there, and I'm like, what the fuck?
All right, so let's go into the next room. As you appear, before you take yourselves too far, please, let me finish my damn sentence!
Oh. You know who's going to stop you from doing arson? That person. Right there.
I feel like that all day with our kids. Can I just finish my sentence?
All right.
Sounds about right.
Okay.
Yep.
Towering.
What were you saying earlier about kids and letting you have a word in?
Don't fucking have them. That's what I was saying. And no, mine interrupts me all the time. Constantly.
Towering.
Me up the wall.
Where okay, hold on. Everybody stop talking. We've interrupted Matt like 7 times. I'm feeling so bad right now.
Sorry, Matt.
Towering yellow mushrooms cover the floor of this vast cave, some reaching over 10 feet in height. They seem to emit a pale light, giving the entire chamber an eerie glow. Shattered remnants of barrels, torn open with their contents nowhere to be seen, lay scattered around the base of the mushrooms. Somewhere off on the far side of the chamber, something stirs, and a faint snarl comes from the shadows.
Look, it's Fungi!
Val puts his hand on Mary's shoulder and he's like, hold on a second. Get sneaky. And Val goes in front of her.
Okay. Where's that one? All the way at the bottom. Alright, so are you standing in front of me or behind me for this one?
I am in front of you.
Fine. I will pretend to be sneakies.
Okay.
So I'm very, very quietly going to try and get him here.
Loxie, would you and your faithful hounds like to join us?
Try and use the mushrooms as cover, because I'm assuming, as far as the map is concerned, like, these ones... this one and this one over here is probably going to be enough cover for me to sneak around.
Yeah, one sec.
He's reading, so let's pause a moment.
Okay.
So you are... wanting to go up here.
Yeah, come up this way.
So the cover is the big mushrooms. So anything that's like this size, your size. So there's a spot, there's a gap here until this one.
Mhm.
Yeah. that sort of thing. So each of those gaps, you potentially.
So does this one here just below me count as cover?
It would, but you'd have to get there first. So, you know, you have to, like, sneak around here.
Sneak up here.
Yeah. So that will be your stealth check for this part. And then you'll need to make it again to get to the other side.
Okay.
She'll do the ninja role like in movies, which is ultra super stealthy, so she completely avoids all forms of detection. All
right, so I'm going to stop you right here. I'm going to stop you right there.
Okay.
So as you get to there, I have something to read out. A bright green dragon leaps into view.
No.
And although the beast isn't much larger than you, large leathery wings and snapping jaws make the hatchling look like an ancient worm. The creature gazes at you, Mariziel, with cunning eyes and snorts a cloud of yellow vapor. With a fierce roar, the dragon charges forward to attack. So, I need you all to make initiative rolls.
I pray that I am faster. Because I will straight up just throw myself in front of that bitch for you, Miz. Or Mary. Also, Houndmaster, if he's still here.
Yes, he is. Thank you.
Here's to hoping Ez can freeze him first.
Okay, so I'm going to take these guys here, and that one there. Hang on, move that one out of the way. That one to there. Stop that. Okay, and he can roll initiative. Bop. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, him and you. Okay. Right, with that, Howlmaster Loxie, having seen the dragon, commands his dogs. Get him! Dogs will... 1, 2, 3, 4, they can get
just,
there.
Just straight up says, get him.
Get him. Dogs will ride on in and make an attack. Actually, no, they will not.
Not words.
They get there, but that's about it. And then he will come behind here. Begin encounter. Ezran.
I do believe this would be the time to panic.
good idea. That's a good spell. Make it panic.
I wish. However, I will do this for you. Kill the beast! Yeah.
Burning everything. So,
Did you take 10 minutes?
Yeah, back when we were healing. She was doing healing on the two of them.
Okay.
I thought I said it. Did I forget to say that I was going to go ahead and refocus while she was healing?
I might have missed it because I got lots that I'm paying attention to.
It's fine. I was pretty sure I said I did it.
Okay.
I apologize if I didn't.
No. That's okay.
Good if we need.
All good. No. So that is going. You're in range for that?
Is magic weapon ranged? I thought it was. Oh, touch.
Wow.
Never mind. I would have to move up to him to do magic weapon. I didn't realize
it
would.
You can do that to Kyra.
I could do it to Kyra's weapon. Do we want to?
I have the smoking sword, which gives me plus one. So.
Okay, if you want to do it to Kyra's, that's fine with me.
Yeah, I hit reliably. I deal damage pretty reliably. Help Kyra.
Okay. I'll put it on Kyra.
Crossbow or scimitar, Kyra?
Do you plan to use your crossbow or your scimitar?
I keep trying to use my
we're fighting range. A dragon. Okay. She prefers range, so crossbow.
Especially with the dragon.
There we go.
Cool.
Alright. So you've cast magic
out
weapon
of force.
And you've done damage with the force bolt. Okay. Oops, what have I done? That's not what I meant to do.
Private roll.
All right. We are good.
No,
it's all good. Yeah, I've got lots to track here. Valoros.
All right, so I haven't been able to do this yet as an effective or in an effective way. I have what is it? God, I have so many like actions. What's the one where I charge an attack?
That would be sudden charge.
Why don't I see it? There's so many things here. Oh, it's the first one. I'm just blind.
Yeah, well, you can do it. You can move up to two movements. So you could actually get behind it if you want.
I will do that. And that's two actions, correct?
Yeah, you also get the strike as part of it, yes.
Before I did that, could I have stoked the flames? Because that's an action. Concentrate until the end of your turn. The blade deals 1d6 extra fire damage instead of just one.
Yeah. Yeah, you can stoke the flames, which means that you get one attack, just this one attack.
Correct.
Yeah, go ahead.
And since you're on the other side, that was smart, because that means you made him flat-footed.
Is there anything special I'd do for flat-footed, or...
Nope.
You shouldn't need to.
I will apply it.
Hey!
You hit, so do your damage.
Hell yeah.
Woo!
Alright. Takes
it. So, the dog's, like, get its attention. I run around the mushroom here, and I, like... This thing's about the size of, like, a small bear, right?
Yeah.
I run up behind it and I'm like, Smoky Sword, go! And I stab it like in the base of its tail.
And as you strike toward it, you see its tail striking at you. And fortunately for you, it misses, but you see that it can strike with its tail.
Yay, missed, yay.
Mary?
Where is it? There. So, I should be able to move up to there. So it's now on three sides, and hit it with the short sword again. Because why not?
You hit it.
Yay!
Oof. Right.
Holy shit.
Well, it, yeah.
Magical shit.
It's taking a whole butt ton of damage.
That should leave me with one more action, shouldn't it?
You've moved, you've attacked.
Yep. Not hit it again?
You can try. Oh.
Looking a gift horse in the mouth.
Alright, it is the wormling's turn.
Did good.
Yeah, that was a lot of damage. Okay. Alright.
Be sure to beat this thing into submission. We need a good pet. Or a mascot.
Oh, this one we can keep as a pet. The deadly, horrifying dragon.
Okay. It is going to fly.
Thanks, TK. I knew that would get you to say something like that.
To here. And then...
Uh-oh, is it gonna do a cone? Oh no.
It's the dragon. They tend to do that. One trick ponies.
They're one trick lizards. Thank you.
Still don't know.
Shyly pushing up glasses on your nose as you say that. Actually.
Let me see if I can move this.
Four legs and a tail. Meh.
Should be.
Four legs and a tail. It's a horse.
It's a horse.
Either way, it is going to get. Just looking. It is going to get the four of you. I don't think there's any other... Yeah, so it's going to get four of you. Yeah. So it breathes out a toxic cloud. I need you all to make this reflex save, please.
Oh,
oh no. Okay. I goofed.
And you already spent your hero point, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh,
I haven't, though.
No.
I'm gonna use my last hero point and re-roll that.
Oh, I'm down.
Oh, god damn it!
Alright, 22 points of poison damage. These dogs are dead.
No! May I activate my rage from my secret barbarian feature?
Well, first you need to take the damage.
I'm unconscious. You don't get it. Can you imagine every encounter? You're gonna take this much damage. I don't wanna. And it just continues. No.
Alright, so Mariziel. Oh, you re-rolled, yep. Right? So just, okay.
Yes.
So dying one. Dying one for Val.
This bitch better be close to dead, goddammit.
Okay.
I was about to ask if it looks like it's bleeding or not, because I might just have to take Kyra and Ned out.
Bye, Val!
Yeah.
It was good knowing you.
All right, so
the door hit in the ass on the way out.
That's its turn, Kyra.
Is my crossbow gonna do anything?
Yeah. If you hit with it.
Yeah.
It will do damage.
Okay. The crossbow.
So it's 45 feet. What's the range increment on that?
60?
I don't remember. That's why I'm going to check if it is. Range increment 120 feet. Yeah, no, you're good.
You are definitely good.
So, yeah, you want to...
Yes, crossbow.
Crossbow him.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently she's cross with him.
Yeah.
Do I need to have a black arrow? Do I need to have a black arrow?
No.
No.
But apparently it's harder to hit than a 20. A 20 missed.
A 20 missed.
It's because it has to have, it has to hit that one scale. One scale.
Yeah. That's harsh.
Yep. It's a dragon, man. What do you expect?
A little bit of politeness. Just a little bit.
Politeness, and letting us attack him? Sure.
Yeah, honestly, like, is that so much to ask for?
Alright, so your crossbow
apparently,
misses.
Yes.
You've fired, reloaded, and fired. So that is all of your actions. Houndmaster, like, with both of his dogs going down, he's just like, no! You will not!
Bring it down!
It'd be hilarious if he's just like, Val, you son of a bitch! He starts kicking me.
Alright, so...
You defile my daughter and kill my dogs, you worthless!
Track. Damage. 4. Okay, takes it. Alright, there we go. Does 4 damage to it. Ezrin?
Lord, we did.
Oh, also, when the Houndmaster comes into range, the tail whips out to try and hit him and misses, fortunately. Magic missile automatically hits. So I'll apply some damage.
Why one? Stop with the ones already.
It doesn't want to. Damage, damage, and damage. Okay, takes all of that.
You got home.
Well, you've spent 3 actions. Val, you are dying. I need you to make a recovery check, please.
Let's see, where's recovery?
It's beside your dying condition, there's a little tiny dice. You do succeed, so, your dying reduces by 1.
While I'm dying, I'm just like...
Stable.
In this nebulous void space, and I'm just like... Who is that girl? The barmaid?
Alright.
They're at...
Mary, I need you to make a death save, a recovery check, rather. It's not a death save, it's a recovery check. Ooh, you fail. Your death dying goes up to 2.
I'm going to need to burn these dice when we're done. Thank you.
They're digital.
All right.
I will burn them. I will find a way to fucking burn them.
Dragon. Goes into a draconic frenzy, making 2 claw strikes and a tail strike.
Oh, and now he's got frenzy. Wow. What a prick.
So 2 claw. Damage. Another claw. Misses. And a tail? Yeah, tail strike. Damage. Okay, so 18 points of damage to the Houndmaster.
Val, you might need to live to take care of his daughter.
Uh,
fly to here. What is this? I just want to double check this for a second. Okay. Yep, got that. Wonderful. That's its turn, Kyra.
We're gonna heal Mary. Try to resurrect her.
Yep.
Do you wanna spend three and heal? Oh wait, are you within range to heal? Do the three? I don't think so. Give me a second. 30 foot. I think you're out of 30 foot. I think they're just out of range.
Mary's in range, but Val is not.
So, yeah, I guess you can do that. You want to go up and heal Mary?
Yeah.
Well, you're within range with Mary, so I guess you could heal one, but then one action. No, I'd only heal her. I'm just saying that. Yeah, you can do that. I'm just thinking that you have one action left. What do you want to do with it? I guess you can reload the crossbow. Okay.
All right, so you'll cast a heal, which will be the two actions versus living. And then you press the healing button. And Mary, you will heal for 15.
God damn.
Take the dying condition off, but let me have a look at this. Casting does not remove wounded. So I will take those off you and then give you wounded. Alright, wounded, 1, 2. There we go. Alright, that is Kyra's turn. Houndmaster. He's looking pretty wounded right now. He will run up and try to hit the dragon. Strike. Ooh. Nope. As he tries to overreach, because the dragon is quite a significant way up those mushrooms, he drops his whip. Looks dejected. He's like, I think that's about all I've got. Ezrin.
I think Val has an extra sword you can use.
And a short bow.
It may be of damage in the last battle as he hit the chair with it, but you could use it.
I'm going to do something interesting.
Yeah.
The Wand of Healing says you can cast heal. Is it the same way as the healing spell itself?
All right. PF2 wand. Okay, you can try to figure out what the spell is in it. If the spell is a common spell from your spell list, you can use a single recall knowledge action.
Ew.
So
I might need to slide it in Kyra's pocket since I don't technically know that spell, or
wand contains a spell that can be cast once a day. It requires holding the wand and activating the item with a caster spell activity. To cast a spell, it must be on your spell list.
Okay. So I would need to give it to her then.
Yes.
Okay. I didn't realize that. Can I have given that to Kyra then? Because
yes.
I did not realize that yet. And I think Ezrin would have. but I'm not as smart as him.
Yeah, for sure. I think so too. I will grab it and give it to her.
I put it on her.
You did? Okay, cool.
Yeah, because since I have
control. You have control of both. Yep.
Yep.
All right, what are you doing?
So I won't do that. Instead, I'll do this one instead. I am going to cast an extra magic missile from a scroll.
Okay.
How do I use it? How do I say to
use? Should just say use on it, hopefully.
Scroll. Edit item. Held item?
I don't even... Oh, there it is. So... edit. You should maybe be able to drag magic missile. Yeah. So we can do this.
Not saying I cast it. But I did cast it right at the top, so I can just...
Yeah, just... Yeah, so we'll just delete it. Off there. Yes. Nice, nice damage.
Hey, magic missile.
Damage. Damage.
And I see you took the scroll. Perfect.
Damage.
Figured right about now is a good time to use it.
And why is Ezran taking that damage? Can you heal yourself for all of that, please?
Why did I take that damage?
I must have
targeted me.
Targeted you. I apologize.
I'm all glad right. We noticed it.
Takes it. Alright. It's looking wounded.
I did it, but it says I don't have permissions to update chat log.
That's right. Weird.
All right. Looks like I have my health back. That's all that matters.
Yeah, that's...
We good.
Val, you are still unconscious. I need a recovery check.
Sorry, you don't have medicine, Val.
Oh, no, because you're stable. You're stable. It's just, you're just unconscious. It's fine. Yep. All right. Mary, you are awake, Mary, but your weapon is on the ground, and you are prone currently. You're also wounded. The creature is up on an elevated platform on the mushrooms, out of your reach at the moment.
Acrobatics up there and stab it in the face.
I was thinking that, but I can't see myself doing that while I'm not feeling so great.
You got, what was it, 15 health? You're perfect. Fly up there, then. You still have your fly, right?
You too.
Okay, so... This is just what I'm thinking, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to do all of it, but...
Lena's back and right him.
That is definitely not what I was thinking. I have a health potion. Am I able to force Val to drink the health potion?
Yes, you can click use, and then Val will press the heal. Yeah.
And that's one action?
No, it's two actions.
Okay.
I believe Kyra can heal him next turn as well. If you
it would be good to do more than just the one though. Because
I just also know to bring the dragon down, and if she spends two actions to do it, then she's not able to reach
him. Very true. Just go teleport on top of his back with your flying thing. And then stab him in the neck.
Okay.
Up to you.
Too many things. All right,
so I'm healing that much?
Yes.
You're healing that much? Okay, so it only gives me one more action, so the fly and stab?
Well, you can stand.
Does that fit into one?
You could stand, or you can fly, but you can't do all the things.
she go stealth?
Possibly. I mean, I think you're in sight. I think you would have to move before you could do that.
Okay, so if I then chose to move around behind here.
Yep, you can do that. As you do, the tail strikes at you.
Of course it fucking does.
The 14.
No, you still got 1 HP. You're good.
Alright, you get to the other side of it. It does that.
Yeah.
Okay. And then it's its turn. It will go to here.
Wait. Oh yeah, because she didn't...
And then it will let out a breath weapon on Ezrin and Kyra. I need you both, please, to make...
Us?
Because you're there. Make that reflex save.
Welcome to the party.
It's a fail.
Party.
That's a critical fail. And so, Ezrin, you take double, and Kyra, you take 18.
Awesome.
Ezrin's taking a nap, guys. It's because he's an old man.
Yeah, probably. Maybe.
All right, it breathes out.
I'm dead. And
well, you're unconscious, so you are on dying 2 because you critically failed.
Can I use my hero point to not be...
On your turn, you can get up. Okay.
Yeah, you gotta be dying for a little bit.
Alright, so Kyra is okay, but poison all over your stuff.
Right. I gotta step away to deal with the dog. She'll still be here to listen in.
Alright, and Kyra, it is your turn. You think that the dragon is wounded, but you've got several companions down. It's up to you how you want to do this. Apparently not.
Hello?
Hello. Alright, so she has a wand, and she has burning hands, and she has... what other spells? She has stabilize. Does anyone... So she could cast stabilize. Hello.
Sorry, guys.
You're okay. What are you doing?
I'm muted, but, and I didn't. I couldn't figure it out. Okay. Okay. So, how much health does the dragon have?
You don't know, but it looks badly wounded, or seriously wounded.
And I'm the only one still alive.
No. You see, Mary is up just barely.
I am also up just
barely. Just barely, yeah.
So, and this dragon has a very high hit.
Yeah, it's got scaly skin that makes it difficult to hit, yes.
So the two best people for hitting that AC is me and Miri, but also possibly Ez. The thing is, we're all one hit away from going down.
Yeah.
Again.
Okay. So, who, between the two of you, who has a higher likelihood of being able to get the dragon? Like, you have a...
It probably Val.
In terms of track record of success for hitting,
okay,
I statistically have the best.
Okay, then I will. Oh, what did I just do? I will heal you. Except, wait, hold on.
You clicked me.
Oh.
So when you click me, that happens because you can't see things.
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna heal Val.
Okay. Val is 35 out. You can only do 30, so you have to move.
Okay.
I would suggest moving down over here. Actually, you can fly 30. You can, or 40. You can use that and get over here.
Okay. I'll do that, and then I can be more shielded.
And then you can heal him, since that's what you want to do. Really? Well, it's something.
It's 5.
And then you can loose the crossbow if you want.
Yeah.
No. Because it's a single action. Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
You miss. But, clink!
I guess I need to.
You're doing real good. Very good. Clerics are very good at the spells and tend to be less good at the fighting, except for with their spells. But, you know, you're doing real well. Be very proud of yourself. Okay.
Thanks.
All right. Howlmaster is going to grab his whip for an action, move up to the creature.
Toss a coin to your witcher, O Valley of Plenty, O Valley of Plenty. Oh.
Thank you for the bits. 20 bits again. 40 bits today. Please be careful with your own money. Thank you very much. Targets. And strikes. Ooh, just barely hits.
Yay!
Well, 5.
So, 22 at target.
Yeah.
I think 21 missed. I know 20 missed. I don't know if 21. But 22 hit, so that's what matters.
Alright. It takes the damage! Very close to death.
I expended all of my spells and died.
Ezrin, need a recovery check.
Nah, I'm dead.
You're dead?
No.
You can spend your hero point to just remove all your dying if you wish.
What do you guys think? Should I go for it?
Just roll, yeah.
So single success removes one dying, so we take it down to 1. There we go. You are still dying at the moment.
Okay, he said to leave it. I'll leave it.
Okay. Val.
Charge!
You are prone, so.
Kill me, Val.
You would have to stand first.
Okay, I'll do that.
And then you can sudden charge.
Sudden charge. It's flat-footed now, right?
You'd have to get to there.
Can he jump off the wall to make it flat-footed across from the guy?
Yeah, I don't mind him being here. Mechanically has to be there, yeah.
It was kind of tight, so I was trying to ask.
Oh! Oh, yeah!
All right. Wow. You want to roll that? Critical? Ooh! All right. Well, how do you do it, Val?
So, Val gets up And he goes, "Nobody screws over Ez but me!" And he looks like he's rocketing towards the dragon. The dragon flicks its tail. Val jumps over it, bounces off the wall, pins it to the ground with his shield, and then lays the smoking sword, kind of singeing his hand as he does so, and jams the hilt into the dirt, cutting the head off the dragon.
Nice. As he hacks away at the head of the dragon, the sound of roaring fades, and everything is still. Let's see if this says anything.
I'm dying here.
Oh, stop complaining, old man. I pour a potion down his throat.
So there is a chest up on a ledge. I will pop it over here where the ledge is, but just so you know, there is a chest that you can see up on a ledge.
I look to Loxie and I'm like, "You can have my share. Those valiant beasts did not deserve to die this way."
All right.
Sorry, I need a minute.
He'll go over there and check it out. Someone's already taken it. He gets over there and he's like, "It's empty! It's empty, Val! What chair are you talking about?"
Val's there, like, coughing.
"Mary,
what do you want?" I did it out of habit since I'd been storing our wealth to catalog it for everyone.
All
right. I did nothing.
But hey, it's in chat.
Exactly. I totally thought it was you. You're the thief.
Oh, you can see in chat who it is.
Okay.
And you can see exactly how much.
He's like, "Phil, it's empty."
And he goes, "No, Ezrin just magically has all the money."
"I used Mage Hand. It's delightful."
He comes back. He's like storming at you, Ezra. And he's like, "I will have my share. Give."
There's an emerald hanging in front of his face as he storms over towards Val.
Oh yes, I'll have that. I'll grab it and emerald.
Val is gonna start, he's gonna take his dagger out and he's gonna start cutting pieces off the dragon.
Okay. You start hacking away at the dragon.
It's dragon parts. Is this not valuable?
You can make a survival or nature check.
Survival or nature?
Yeah.
Crafting wouldn't apply here. Survival. Where's my nature? Do I not have nature? Oh, yeah. It's plus zero. That's why. All right. Survival then. Shit.
He starts. Yeah. He's just hacking it.
Advising how to do it properly.
All right.
What were the two rolls you said?
Nature or survival?
Yeah, they're the same.
Yeah, Val, just really get in there, twist the dagger around, make sure all the scales are mushed.
You just
head. That's the important part.
You're just butchering.
Yeah. From there, be sure to individually, one by one, peel off the scales. You know how you scale a fish, right? The bass, you scale it. You have to scale it first.
Go on.
Well, and once that done, then we can move on to the extricating other part.
Oh, okay.
I believe there's a kidney in the region of its tail.
In the region?
Region. I'm sore throat from dying almost.
All right.
What are the chances that Mary has understanding of how the breath weapon works?
You can make a recall knowledge check. It will be, it's a dragon, so it's Arcana.
Ew. Yeah, this is...
She understands it quite well.
So if I understand it quite well, does that mean that I understand that there may be a specific part of the dragon that performs this action? How I might extricate that from the corpse.
Sure. You understand that there is a chemical reaction that happens inside of the dragon to create this. The dragon has to concentrate on it for that to happen. And it will sort of make a chemical reaction and then breathe it out. You think that the dragon has to actually do that for the chemical reaction to take place. You're not sure how you would manufacture that, but you can get the compounds inside of its body that are in two, like, sections, and maybe experiment later with seeing how those things might be combined without the dragon doing it. But you would have to extricate them, so that's a nature or survival check.
Yeah, we're going for survival because that's a +6 and I'm still gonna fail it.
All right, as you plunge your dagger into this.
Yeah, just like how you heal people, Miri.
Exactly.
a burst of poison issues.
Oh my god.
From it. I could make everyone in the area to make a save. Instead, Mary, you're the one that opened it. I need you to make a fortitude save, please. Okay. You succeed and take half damage. You're gonna take half damage.
You know, I'm dead.
Oh my god.
It's only half damage. Like,
it's only half damage. I only had one hit point. I'm dead.
Yeah. Mary bursts the poison gizzard and a burst of poison comes out. She collapses on the ground before Kyra manages to tend to her wounds and bring her back from the brink of death. You know now that you have punctured the gizzard and you do no longer have the opportunity to gather the reagents from it. And you can make your way stumbling and half dead. Back to the surface.
We should return with this beast's head.
Yeah,
back to our benefactor, collect our wealth, our good earnings, and go and sleep for a week.
I'm gonna buy a dog. You guys think we should get a dog? As Val just starts walking out with the head.
As you emerge from the tunnels, you finally feel fresh air, and you just, I don't know, it's just a sweet breeze. With courage and luck, you survived your encounter with the kobolds and their pet, returning to town as triumphant heroes. Tamalee feels truly relieved to learn that the threat is fully gone, especially after learning just how dangerous it was. Over the coming weeks, news of the heroes' exploits travel all across town, and soon they receive opportunities for more adventuring work. And you are published in the Otari Gazetteer as heroes.
guys, you have survived your first endeavor into Pathfinder 2nd Edition, the beginner box, Troubles of Atari. I've been Matt in the Hat. I hope you enjoyed this session. Let's have one last little section from you guys as you sit in an inn about a week after all of these troubles. Let's put us back to this map. You are so sitting around the inn.
Go ahead. Successfully survived. What should we do now?
Well, I guess now I'm too high profile to be a guard, so, you know, that's kind of out of the question. I mean, I'm sure there's other places that has dragons, right? Like, that's an issue.
I don't know that we should be trying to fight dragons. That kind
of. We're experts in the field now. That was at least 10 hours of dragon slaying experience. That makes us an expert.
If we're anything expert, it's almost dying. You're welcome.
I think what you mean to say is that we're experts at surviving. See, it's all about phrasing.
I heard Miri say that she's interested in going with you, and she will tend to your every wound.
No fucking likely.
Val starts running away. No!
Val!
I'm not ready to die!
Maybe it's just your time.
Oh, God. Alright. Awesome.
Everyone's gonna die sometime, so...
Yeah. Mary, you're not helping the situation.
I'm not trying to help it.
You may be short-lived humans compared to your illustrious self, but we still appreciate our short, puny lives.
Oh, fine. I'll stop trying to kill everyone.
Very good.
That's fun.
Hey, Matt, for one... I appreciate it that you ran it. It was been a blast.
It has.
Yeah.
I like
my smoky sword.
You are very welcome. It has been a pleasure to have all of you, to get to know you a little bit, and to be playing a role-playing game together. We will discuss what is next for us in the great land of role-playing. And see what we want to do next. But more than likely, by the sounds of the, I don't know, the general vibe around our imaginary table, our digital table, it sounds like we might want to do some more things. So watch this space, everybody. And if we do decide to do something, we will make it official. There will be a schedule in place. There will be some interactions on the channel where you can potentially give hero points to either the party or to enemies to have shenanigans with. So we'll see what that looks like in the coming weeks as we discuss what happens, because there is a possibility of other RPGs and stuff as well. So we need to get that sorted first, but we'll see. We'll update you soon with what we come up with. Thank you to each and every one of the players. I'm going to give you another shout out as we finish up. Oh, let's go around the table. What have you enjoyed the most as part of this adventure? What are you taking away from these four sessions? Yes.
I need to burn more dice as a ritualistic kind of symbolism to make the dice do as I want them to, maybe?
What you need to do is you need to go and buy a large supply.
A chest.
And you
bag.
Need to create a whole layout and have a big ordeal of sacrificing these dice.
Sounds good.
To enhance your probabilities of success.
Or maybe we can do that for you because he has a huge selection.
I don't have that many.
I don't have enough to roll 300 orcs. So I don't have enough.
Fair enough. All right, so what is our takeaway, guys? Yeah, you can go ahead, Lady DM Nyx, and say what has been your takeaway.
To not get cocky about how great I roll at the beginning.
Yes, that's a good takeaway. It's a good lesson.
And I really appreciate the clickable
the automated character.
Automated, yes.
Awesome.
The first time I played, I was trying to create this digital note thing and all the comments, and it was just too much.
Yeah.
So it's really cool they have this and
yeah. I'm glad that you've had fun, and I'm glad that you've learnt something. It's been wonderful to have you around the table, so thank you for joining us, and maybe we'll see you again, or hear you again, as the case may be. Yeah, but it's been a great pleasure. How about you, Table Knights?
I learned that sometimes just because something's cute doesn't mean that it's your friend. It was a difficult lesson for me to learn.
It is difficult.
I will forget that lesson by tomorrow.
Excellent. Sounds just like real life. All right. The Lady Vengeance, what is your takeaway?
Then I need to do more of this. And then I need to burn more dice.
That's a good takeaway.
I mean, honestly, I had forgotten how much I enjoyed playing, so because it has been a long time, so definitely maybe getting into things that I used to do that I don't really do so much anymore would be my takeaway.
Awesome. And finally, DM Nyx, your takeaway.
I have played 5e, and I played Pathfinder, and I played 3.5. I like it. I like that it's more simple than some of the chaos of 3.5 could get. Those who know that it was very crunchy and lots of math and lots of modifiers and ups and downs and could get a bit complicated.
Mm-hmm.
So I like that it was simpler, but I do like that it's more tactical than 5e. 5e is kind of, you play it the same way, almost indistinguishing of which class you have and stuff. But in this, like a good example of it that I found was the whole attack of opportunity. It's a feature that only some have.
Yeah.
And so moving around in combat and being more tactical and, planning things through, it's also more dangerous, I would say, in a lot of ways. But I like that it was more tactical and in depth without being overly complicated.
All right. Well, thank you for that feedback. Well, with all of that, it is pretty much time to wrap up here. Thank you, everybody that's been watching. Thank you especially to Dragon, who's donated 40 bits today, and to Raven Rolls for subscribing, and to also Dragon for the gifted sub to the Bootius Maximus. So I hope that the Bootius Maximus enjoys their gifted sub. And I will be back maybe tonight. I'll see how I feel, but I might play some The Room or I might play some Risk. We'll see how things go. But we're going to head off now and just do some group care, do some self-care. I encourage everybody that's watching to do the same. Look after yourselves. Take care of yourselves. I will be back soon. And until then. I've been Matt in a Hat. This has been our lovely cast, and we bid you farewell. Good afternoon, good evening, good morning, wherever you are. Good day. Catch you next time. Actually, let's see if we've got someone to raid out to. What is up?
So if I'm gonna be getting...
Ooh, we Clo caffeinated is on. Let's raid out to Clo. Raid. And let's put us to the ending screen. Caffeinated. All right. Feel free to copy the raid message, guys, as we head over to give Clo Caffeinated, another great Australian streamer and a very cool chick, some love. Alright. Bye for now. Good.